So here with Robert Nemeth, the Conservative Councillor for the Wish Ward from Brighton Hove City Council. For this episode of The Vote, we're going to start off talking about the bin strike. Obviously, bins overflowing across the city. It can change at any moment, we should say that. So by the time this goes out, it might have changed. We just don't know. But at the moment, the bins are full and the streets are looking pretty messy, aren't they?
Yeah, I've just walked here along Queen's Road and down West Street, and I just dread to think what any tourist would be thinking if this was their first visit to Brighton.
Yeah, exactly. It's not the first time either. We've had this before, but under previous Green administration with Jason Kitcat.
Yeah. I don't know if I want to link the two things, but there probably is a link between strikes and Green administrations.
Right. What's your take on it then, and how do you think it can be resolved?
Well, I mean, it's probably worth spending a couple of minutes talking about what the union's gripes are, because I don't think the public at large know exactly why the bin men are striking, and I think the public need to make their own mind up on whether or not it's justified. So there's a series of linked concerns that the union has about treatment of their workers, and it's things like ensuring that drivers and crews are kept on the round that they're allocated to, you know, the round that they know, the round that they do most days when they're at work. That's probably the primary concern. There's concerns of the union that drivers are being managed and workers are being managed out of their usual round as a response to poor performance. So they're using the moving of workers around as a disciplinary procedure. Third thing is about how when a rep is on trade union duty, how their round is covered in their absence.
Yep.
Then there's various, linked concerns about how permanent staff and agency staff are treated differently.
Right.
So, and then that links to things like what happens to a round when drivers are unwell. So it's not that clear cut. I'm not sure.
It's not pay related then, is it?
It pay has been brought into it because it's now a question of, well, if workers are going to do those things, then they want more pay to do it. So they're not things that, they're not saying we won't do those things full stop. They're saying if we are to do those things, then we need to be paid more to do it. So it's become pay related.
Right, okay. And so do you know how it's going to be resolved? I mean, it's all the party leaders are talking, aren't they? There are discussions behind the scenes because City Clean is a council-run organisation now. Not everyone knows that because it used to be privatised, didn't it?
Well, I suppose it's probably worth giving the roles of the different groups that are involved. Yeah. So the Green Party is, in some senses, partnered with Labour to be the minority administration of the city. The GMB union represents the workers and fights hard for their cause, but ultimately is loyal to the workers. Conservative group is the second opposition party, so can stand back a bit and try and give a balanced view of what's happening. And the Labour group's in the strangest position because it's very intertwined with the workings of the GMB union. So lots of the Labour councillors are members of the GMB. So they have a sort of split loyalty where they're elected to represent their residents for the best of the city, but they're also part of the GMB itself. And there's probably a dynamic happening here where there's a very orchestrated campaign for a strike to hurt the Greens, which Labour will definitely have their hands all over.